السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن والاه. Welcome to session number 25 of our daily recitations and reflections. So today we're beginning from Juz number 7, and that is verse number 83. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. وإذا سمعوا ما أنزل إلى الرسول ترى أعينهم تفيض من الدمع مما عرفوا من الحق يقولون ربنا آمنا فاكتبنا مع الشاهدين وما لنا لا نؤمن بالله وما جاءنا من الحق ونطمع أن يدخلنا ربنا مع القوم الصالحين فأثابهم الله بما قالوا جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها وَذَٰلِكَ جَزَاءُ الْمُحْسِنِينَ وَالَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا وَكَذَّبُوا بِآيَاتِنَا أُولَٰئِكَ أَصْحَابُ الْجَحِيمِ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تُحَرِّمُوا طَيِّبَاتِ مَا أَحَلَّ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ وَلَا تَعْتَدُوا إن الله لا يحب المعتدين وكلوا مما رزقكم الله حلالا طيبا واتقوا الله الذي أنتم به مؤمنون لا يؤاخذكم الله باللغو في أيمانكم ولكن يؤاخذكم بما عقدتم الأيمان فكفارته إطعام 10 مساكين من أوسط ما تطعمون أهليكم أو كسوتهم أو تحرير رقبة فمن لم يجد فصيام 3 أيام ذلك كفارة أيمانكم إذا حلفتم واحفظوا أيمانكم كذلك يبين الله لكم آياته لعلكم تشكرون يا أيها الذين آمنوا إنما الخمر والميسر والأنصاب والأزلام رجس من عمل الشيطان فاجتنبوه لعلكم تفلحون إنما يريد الشيطان أن يوقع بينكم العداوة والبغضاء في الخمر والميسر ويصدكم عن ذكر الله وعن الصلاة فهل أنتم منتهون وأطيعوا الله وأطيعوا الرسول واحذروا فإن توليتم فاعلموا أنما على رسولنا البلاغ المبين ليس على الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات جناح فيما طعموا إذا ما اتقوا وآمنوا وعملوا الصالحات ثم اتقوا وآمنوا ثم اتقوا وأحسنوا والله يحب المحسنين يا أيها الذين آمنوا ليبلونكم الله بشيء من الصيد تناله أيديكم ورماحكم ليعلم الله من يخافه بالغيب فمن اعتدى بعد ذلك فله عذاب أليم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تقتلوا الصيد وأنتم حرم ومن قتله منكم متعمدا فجزاء مثل ما قتل من النعم يحكم به ذوى عدل منكم هديا بالغ الكعبة أو كفارة طعام مساكين أو عدل ذلك صياما ليذوق وبال أمره عفى الله عما سلف ومن عاد فينتقم الله منه والله عزيز ذو انتقام. أحل لكم صيد البحر وطعامه متاعا لكم وللسيارة وحرم عليكم صيد البر ما دمتم حرما واتقوا الله الذي إليه تحشرون. جعل الله الكعبة البيت الحرام قياما للناس والشهر الحرام والهدي والقلائد ذلك لتعلموا أن الله يعلم ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وأن الله بكل شيء عليم. يعلموا أن الله شديد العقاب وأن الله غفور رحيم. ما على الرسول إلا البلاغ والله يعلم ما تبدون وما تكتمون. قل لا يستوي الخبيث والطيب ولو أعجبك كثرة الخبيث فاتقوا الله يا أولي الألباب لعلكم تفلحون. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تسألوا عن أشياء إن تبدَ لكم تسؤكم وإن تسألوا عنها حين ينزل القرآن تبدَ لكم عفى الله عنها والله غفور حليم. قد سألها قوم من قبلكم ثم أصبحوا بها كافرين. ما جعل الله من بحيرة ولا سائبة ولا وصيلة ولا حام ولكن الذين كفروا يفترون على الله الكذب وأكثرهم لا يعقلون. وإذا قيل لهم تعالوا إلى ما أنزل الله وإلى الرسول قالوا حسبنا ما وجدنا عليه آباءنا أولو كان آباؤهم لا يعلمون شيئا ولا يهتدون. يا أيها الذين آمنوا عليكم أنفسكم لا يضركم من ضل إذا اهتديتم إلى الله مرجعكم جميعا فينبئكم بما كنتم تعملون. يا أيها الذين آمنوا شهادة بينكم إذا حضر أحدكم الموت حين الوصية اثنان ذوى عدل منكم
أو آخران من غيركم إن أنتم ضربتم في الأرض فأصابتكم مصيبة الموت تحبسونهما من بعد الصلاة فيقسمان بالله إن ارتبتم لا نشتري به ثمنا ولو كان ذا قربى ولا نكتم شهادة الله إنا إذا لمن الآثمين فإن عثر على أنهما استحقا إثما فآخران يقومان مقامهما من الذين استحق عليهم الأوليان فيقسمان بالله لشهادتنا أحق من شهادتهما وما اعتدينا إنا إذا لمن الظالمين ذلك أدنى أن يأتوا بالشهادة على وجهها أو يخافوا أن ترد أيمان بعد أيمانهم واتقوا الله واسمعوا والله لا يهدي القوم الفاسقين يوم يجمع الله الرسل فيقول ماذا أجبتم قالوا لا علم لنا إنك أنت علام الغيوب إذ قال الله يا عيسى ابن مريم اذكر نعمتي عليك وعلى والدتك إذ أيدتك بروح القدس تكلم الناس في المهد وكهلا وإذ علمتك الكتاب والحكمة والتوراة والإنجيل وإذ تخلق من الطين كهيئة الطير بإذني فتنفخ فيها فتكون طيرا بإذني وتبرئ الأكمه والأبرص بإذني وإذ تخرج الموتى بإذني وإذ كففت بني إسرائيل عنك إذ جئتهم بالبينات فقال الذين كفروا منهم إن هذا إلا سحر مبين وإذ أوحيت إلى الحواريين أن آمنوا بي وبرسولي قالوا آمنا واشهد بأننا مسلمون.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. So we'll stop there. That is verse number 111. We will continue from verse number 112 tomorrow, inshallah. So we recited a beautiful set of verses that consists of some of the ethics, some of the qualities of the believers, some rulings with regards to oaths, you know, the promises that people make and then they do not fulfill them. So the expiation with regards to that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the rulings of some animals which have been rendered haram. And some of the animals, like the animals that come out from the water, the ocean, the seas, all of those are halal. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about a set of values. Then again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about a bequest that should be done before a person passes away and he owes people money. So that becomes obligatory upon a person to write down his will. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the incident of Isa alayhi salatu wa salam and the miracles that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted Isa alayhi salatu wa salam and some of the miracles that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave Banu Israel, the Israelites under Musa alayhi salatu wa salam, and that's where the name of this surah is derived, Ma'idah, the story of the table laden with food from the heavens when it was brought in the form of manna and salwa for the Banu Israel, the Israelites, and yet they proved to be defiant. In spite of that, they rejected the call of the messenger and turned their backs against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the conversation that will take place between him and Isa alayhi salatu wa salam in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of Qiyamah. Very beautiful incident, but we are yet to recite those verses. We will recite them tomorrow insha'Allah, and we will understand that therein insha'Allah. So let's look at some of the qualities of the believers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions. The Sahaba and every believing Muslim man and woman should imbibe these qualities. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, the first verse we recited, وَإِذَا سَمِعُوا إِلَى مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَى الرَّسُولِ, when they listen to what has been revealed, تَرَى أَعْيُنَهُمْ تَفِيضُ مِنَ الدَّمْعِ مِمَّا عَرَفُوا مِنَ الْحَقِّ. O Messenger, when they listen to the verses that have been revealed to you, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you will see their eyes overflowing with tears. So their eyes would cascade with tears because they have recognized the truth. بِمَا عَرَفُوا مِنَ الْحَقِّ. يَقُولُونَ, they say, رَبَّنَا, our Lord, آمَنَّا, we have believed in you. فَاكْتُبْنَا مَعَ الشَّاهِدِينَ, so count us among the witnesses. وَمَا لَنَا لَا نُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ, why should we not believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? وَمَا جَاءَنَا مِنَ الْحَقِّ, and in the truth that has come to us. وَنَطْمَعُ أَن يُدْخِلَنَا رَبُّنَا مَعَ الْقَوْمِ الصَّالِحِينَ, and we long for our Lord to include us in the company of our righteous. So this is our hope, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala includes us amongst those people who are righteous. What was the reward of the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anuhum, whose state was what has just been described? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَأَثَابَهُمُ اللَّهُ بِمَا قَالُوا, so Allah will reward them for what they said. بِمَا قَالُوا جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِي مِن تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارُ, they will be rewarded with gardens under which rivers flow. خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا, they will abide therein forever. وَذَلِكَ جَزَاءُ الْمُحْسِنِينَ, and this is the reward of the excellent doers. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us amongst them. So one of the qualities Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِذَا سَمِعُوا مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَى الرَّسُولِ, when they listen to the verses that have been revealed, the Quran is recited to them, تَرَى أَعْيُنَهُمْ تَفِيضُ مِنَ الدَّمْعِ, their eyes overflow with tears. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Anfal, speaking about the believers, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا. The qualities of the believers is of such, إِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا, when they are reminded of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ, their hearts tremble in fear, in awe of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ, when the verses of Allah are recited before them, زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا, they increase in iman. They increase in iman. So we should check our iman. What is our condition when the verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are recited before us? Does it increase us in iman, or does it decrease us in iman? Or we are just there. Probably nothing impacts us. Hence I normally say to those people who are addicted to listening to music, this filth. Remember, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's words and filth, both of them cannot be combined together. They cannot be at the same level. They can't be combined in a believer's heart. And that's why those people who are, you know, kind of obsessed with the listening of music, that's the voice of shaitan, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes it. When the Quran is played before them, their heart is being pinched by shaitan, because he doesn't want them to listen to the verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you will see them giving excuses like, hey, we are talking, man. Switch off that Quran, switch it off. We are talking, you should not be talking while the Quran is being recited. They give such lame excuses. It's not that that is false, it is right. But
That is not their intention. It is to serve their own ulterior motive. It's because shaitan does not want them to listen to the Quran. Hence when the Quran is being played, their hearts are being pinched by shaitan so that they don't listen to it and they hate listening to it. Just like the hypocrites, just like the disbelievers. But the believers, they love reciting the Quran. They love listening to the Quran. And when the Quran is being recited, their eyes overflow with tears and their hearts tremble out of awe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they increase in iman. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in another place, تَخْشَعِرُّ قُلُوبُ الَّذِينَ يَخْشَوْنَ رَبَّهُمْ. Their hands, the hair in the body is left standing out of awe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because of the verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why we should try and understand the message that is being conveyed. We should try and have a connection directly with the Quran of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the message that has been given to us as an ummah, a blessing which is eternal. It will remain until the end of times. And when you have a connection with the Quran, you will be regarded amongst the special slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And once you fall under that category, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of Qiyamah will cause the Quran to fight your case. The Quran will come in your defense and it will hold your hand into Jannah, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stated. Another verse that we recited today, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in verse number 87, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, all those who claim to believe, لا تحرموا طيبات ما أحل الله لكم. Do not forbid the things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made halal. Just don't go about categorizing things under the category of haram. Just don't go saying, this is haram, this is haram. You don't have the authority to label things halal and things haram. That is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has placed in the Quran, and it is a ruling that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has conveyed to us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given that knowledge to the people who have the knowledge of the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So the one who has got an authority to render something halal, to render something haram, that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Him alone. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and do not transgress, وَلَا تَعْتَدُوا, by going about labeling things which Allah has made halal, haram, and things that Allah has made haram, halal. Don't go about doing that. Don't transgress. Don't overstep your mark. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not like those people who transgress. وَكُلُوا مِمَّا رَزَقَكُمُ اللَّهُ حَلَالًا طَيِّبًا. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, eat from the halal and the pure that we have blessed you with. So this is a very important point. In fact, in Surah An-Nahl, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala towards the end, the second last page, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَا تَقُولُوا لِمَا تَصْرِفُ أَلْسِنَتُكُمُ الْكَذِبُ هَذَا حَلَالٌ وَهَذَا حَرَامٌ لِتَفْتَرُوا عَلَى اللَّهِ الْكَذِبُ. Don't go about labeling things, branding things halal, this haram, lest you impose a lie and upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because if you say something is halal, you are indicating that the law maker, that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has made it halal, because He is the one who has got that authority. And if you label something haram, you are indicating that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has rendered it haram. And if that thing has not been rendered haram by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you are imposing a lie on the law maker, the legislator, and that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we have to be careful. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Al-halal bayyin wal-haram bayyin. Halal is clear, and things which are haram, they are clear. What does that mean? Allah has mentioned the haram things in the Quran. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has expounded on what is haram through his ahadith. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, وَبَيْنَهُمَا أُمُورٌ مُشْتَبِهَاتٌ. And between what is clear of halal, clear of haram, are things which are dubious, doubtful matters. That's a gray area. That zone, the knowledge of it is only with the scholars. They are the ones to tell you, this is halal, this is haram, this is a bit doubtful. This component, this ingredient that has been used, this particular agent, stay away from it. You can say that based on knowledge, but you can't do that out of knowledge. If you don't have the knowledge, remain silent. Try and communicate with someone who has the knowledge and ask him, is this halal? Is this haram? lest you fall in the great sin of transgressing and imposing a lie upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about oaths. That's a detailed thing. But let me go into some values that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned. Very valuable values. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ لَا يَسْتَوِي الْخَبِيثُ وَالطَّيِّبُ وَلَوْ أَعْجَبَكَ كَثْرَةُ الْخَبِيثُ. O Muhammad, say to them, the good and the evil are not equal. Halal and haram, they can never be equal. Pure and what is filthy, it can never be at the same level. Though, وَلَوْ أَعْجَبَكَ كَثْرَةُ الْخَبِيثُ. Even if you may be dazzled by the abundance of evil, if evil and filth is so much out there, even if you're amazed by its amount, it will not make it halal. Simply because haram is all over the place doesn't make the thing halal. Even though you are dazzled by the abundance of evil. So be mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, O people of reason, so you may be successful. So you may be successful. Okay. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions that good and evil are not equal, even though you may be dazzled. Even if one can be startled and dazzled and amazed by how much evil is out there, it will not make things halal. The scholars of tafsir say, Al-qalilu al-halal, the less that you have, which is halal, khayrun wa anfa, it's better for you and it's more beneficial for you, min al-kathir al-haram al-dhar, than the haram which is in abundance and it's effective. And it's effective. قُلْ لَا يَسْتَوِ الْخَبِيثُ وَالطَّيِّبُ. Good and evil can never be the same, even if you may be dazzled by how much of evil there is out there. So, always be content with the little that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you. You might look at some person, mashallah, he's got so much. Probably the much that he has is from haram wealth. So that much that he has got is not benefiting him, rather it's affecting him. So if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you little, and that little is out of halal, and you should strive and earn from halal sources, because halal has got barakah. Halal is what will earn you Jannah. Halal is what will make you amongst the tayyibin, the pure slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that's only what will be accepted before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Haram is consequential, it's effective, it has got a lot of effects, and it will affect you. Stay away from it. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying. The little that you have but is halal is better than haram which is in abundance and it has got its harms. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then says, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, O believers, La tas'alu an ashya'a in tubda lakum tasu'kum, wa in tas'alu anha hina yunazzil al-Qur'an, tubda lakum afallahu anha, wallahu ghafurun halim. Verse number 101, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, O believers, do not ask about any matter which, if made clear to you, it might disturb you. Don't be so petty going about asking so many questions with regards to things, if it was made clear to you, the answer was made clear to you, it will disturb you. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, but if you inquire about what is being revealed in the Quran, it will be made clear to you. If you are asking with regards to knowledge that you want so that you could increase in knowledge, you are not intending to despise the scholar, to put him down, to show that he doesn't have the knowledge of that, or to show that you have more knowledge than him, then such a question is haram. But if you're asking in order to get a clarification with regards to a verse, to increase in understanding, not to question about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then that is fine. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if you inquire about what is being revealed in the Quran, it will be made clear to you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forgiven what was done in the past, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is forgiving, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is most forbearing. So do not ask about things that if it would be made clear for you, it would disturb you. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a beautiful hadith, min husni islami al-mar'i tarkuhu ma la ya'ni. If this is the only thing that you will benefit from today's session, it's worth everything outside there. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, min husni, part of the perfection of someone's Islam, of one's religion, is that تَرْكُهُ مَا لَا يَعْنِيهِ. He leaves out that which does not concern him. Matters which are not of your concern, stay away from that. That's part of the perfection of your deen, of your religiosity, of your spirituality, of your values, of your mannerisms. If you want to be amongst those perfect believers, excellent doers, then leave out that which is not of your concern. Mind your own business, as they say. This is an Islamic ethos. It's an Islamic value that we need to abide to. If you come across something, it's not of your concern, don't nitpick. Don't poke your nose in places, in things that are not of your concern. This is good for you, not only you, it's good for your iman, and it's good for you before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the ability to understand what has been said and follow it with righteous actions. We'll continue inshaAllah tomorrow. Until then, subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika, nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Alhamdulillah.